Hello everyone, my name is Philip Balo and I'm an instructor for UCSD Extension. Today we're going to learn how to install Python with Anaconda, as well as learn a small portion of Python programming with a focus on video game mechanics. However, before we jump into Python programming, I wanted to talk a little bit about learning programming with videos. I want you all to understand that not everyone is perfect, and instructors often use tricks to appear that they are coding perfectly. Jump cuts, like these, are often used to cut out mistakes in the video, and we hide the audio cuts with music. Also, I'm reading from a script, and my videos will mostly be voice over video. Furthermore, instructors, like me, have been coding for a long time, so while it may look perfect on video, it took years to get at this level. You are just starting, so don't worry about making mistakes, and in fact, I encourage it. Unless you are working with nuclear missiles, then I'm just gonna say, yeah, just make sure you do it correctly the first time, all right? So, put on your coding gloves, and let's get coding. This first part will be a quick installation tutorial. We will be coding in something called an integrated development environment, also known as an IDE. In this video, we will be using the Spider IDE that comes with Anaconda, but first, we have to install it. First, search for Python Anaconda using your favorite web browser. Please note that you are not looking for a website about snakes, but rather a software website. Or you can just go to anaconda.com. Download the software on their downloads page, install it, and accept all the defaults. Open Spider, and you are done. Part 2, creating a new Python project. All Python files end with a .py extension. It cannot run if you double-click the file unless you add a bit of code to it. For now, to see the results of your Python program, we are going to run Python in the IDE and view the results on Spider's console log. Next, name your project and click on Create. You can change the location of your project folder if you want by clicking on the yellow folder icon. Go to the project pane and right-click on your project folder, then navigate to New, then File. Finally, name your file main.py, then save your project folder. A new tab should have appeared in the editor tab named main.py. Congratulations, you made a new project and created a Python file. Part 3, the print statement. Now that we got statements out of the way, let's do something. The first thing that you will learn will be the print function. This is a very basic way to see the results of something right away. In your main .py file, simply type print left parentheses, double quotes, hello world, double quotes, and right parentheses. Click run on the large screen arrow on the toolbar. A large window should pop up. Click run. You should see something appear on your console log. Congratulations, you made a simple print statement. This is a simple example of an output produced by a computer. Finally, we are going to work on the meat of Python programming, variables. When you create a variable, it is called declaring a variable. You store the value of the variable with an equal sign and a data type value. In this video, the data types we will learn to store include string, also known as text, numbers, and booleans, which are also known as true-false values. To store a string, simply create a variable name, add an equal sign, and a value surrounded by double quotes. To store a number variable, create a variable name, add an equal sign, and a number without any quotes. Finally, to store a boolean variable, create a variable name, add an equal sign, and type either true or false with the first letter capitalized without any quotes. As you can see from the variable explorer of Spider, you can see the different variables, their values, and their data types. Well, that was a bit boring, so let's apply what we learned into something you would probably find in video gaming. Part 5, applying your knowledge. If you want to follow along, copy the following code into your IDE. Be sure to pause the video to give you enough time to copy. Be sure to copy everything perfectly. As you can see from the code, I created a basic text game. In the old days, text-based games were popular, but it required a bit of imagination. This code will only do two things. open a chest, and have an enemy deal damage to the player. Focus only on the variables, as this is just a simple lesson. Watch how I change the variables and how the results change within the console. I highly suggest playing around afterwards to see how variables work. Congratulations, you have taken the first steps into Python programming. If you want to learn more, please check out the Sally Ride Science website, as well as materials provided with this video. The materials include a full Python book, so you don't have to pay for a Python textbook.